Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro with another WordPress related video. I'm your host Bilal Nasir, and today we are practicing some of the commands in WordPress WP and WP-CLI, which is WordPress command line interface, which is the opposite of graphic user interface dashboard, which we have here. So in our first video, we connected this stall via SSH. If you don't know how to connect your WordPress via SSH, please watch out the previous video which I created. So today we are going to practice some of the commands which we commonly use in WP-CLI. So if you are interested to learn, don't skip the video and take a second to subscribe our channel, comment on the video below. Let's get into it. So guys, this is our command line interface. That's how it will look like. And now let's type out the most basic and most oftenly used command, which is WP help, which will give you a list of all the available commands which we have. So these are the commands which we have using WP-CLI. We'll not be going through every single command, but we'll be going through most important ones and the basic ones which are most oftenly used on WordPress operations. So let's get into it. Okay, so our first command is WP core check update, which will check our WordPress core version. If there are any updates available, we can simply check it with this command. Now let's go to our second command, which is WP plugin list. So I'm gonna demonstrate some of the commands which will help you manage the plugins of your WordPress website. So that's the command WP plugin list, which will list all of the plugins which are activated, not activated, and if there's any update available, or if what's the version of that specific plugin. Now if you want to install any new plugin, what you can do is WP plugin install Yoast SEO. Now this command will install the Yoast SEO plugin. Now you must be wondering, where did I get this Yoast SEO name from? So in order to do that, what you can do is go to a WordPress plugin repository and check out the URL of that specific plugin. So for example, if I search for WordPress Yoast SEO plugin, so that's the plugin. And now to install this plugin, I'll have to type in WordPress-SU in our command line. That's good. We find out a mistake. I was typing out Yoast-SU, but it's actually WordPress-SU. So I'm going to type out WordPress-SU to install Yoast-SU plugin. WordPress-SU. Now hit enter and our plugin will be installed in a few seconds. As you can see, it's installing Yoast-SU. Okay, now once your plugin is installed, you will need to activate it. Now if you go and check out your plugin list, you will see that Yoast-SU will be shown as deactivated. Now here's this plugin. As you can see, it's activated. Now to activate the plugin, we will be doing WP plugin activate WordPress SEO. There we go. Our plugin has been activated. Now if we go back to the dashboard of our WordPress install and hit refresh, we can see that our plugin has been activated. As you can see, a new tab just popped out after we activated the plugin. Now if we go to the plugin dashboard, we can see that our plugin has been activated. Now another useful command for plugin is to deactivate the plugin. Now what I'm gonna do is WP plugin deactivate WordPress SEO. Oops, sorry, I did a typo in that. I'm gonna type it in again. WordPress-SEO. successful. The Yoast SEO plugin has been deactivated now. Now, if we go back to the dashboard and hit refresh, we will see that our plugin has been deactivated. Cool. So these are a few of the commands for plugin management. Now we will check out a few of the commands for maintenance, you can say. So one of the command is to flush the cache. So if you have a server level cache attached through your hosting, you can simply flush your cache using WP flush cache command. Oops, sorry, it's not actually WP flush cache, it's WP cache flush. Here we go, our cache has been flushed. Another command is to activate the maintenance mode and deactivate the maintenance mode. So if you are doing any work which you don't want to be visible on your live website, you can simply put on that maintenance mode through your command line, which we will be doing through our maintenance mode command, which is WP maintenance mode activate. Okay, our maintenance mode has been activated. Now if we go back to our website, hit refresh, we can see that the maintenance mode has been activated. We can simply deactivate it using the same command, WP maintenance mode deactivate. And here we go, our maintenance mode has been deactivated. Now if we hit refresh, our maintenance mode has been deactivated. Okay, now check out some of the database related commands. So say if you wanted to export your database, so you can simply type in wpdb export, and what it will do, it will save the database file to your file system. Now let's check out where the file is saved. CD sites, hello, and our stall name is test SSH, and our database should be here somewhere. So if I type in WP export DB, WP DB export, sorry about that, I always replace their position. You need at least one of the processes when trying to. Okay, export it. Now if I check the files again, here we go, we have our database dump exported. Now what you can export the database, and similarly you can also import your database using wpdb import command. So I'm just gonna type it in, wp underscore test ssh. I'll have to manually type in the database name. Okay, here we go, now hit enter. And as you can see, our database has been successfully imported. So if in some case you might need to import the database, you can simply upload your database using file manager to your root folder and simply import it via this command, and also export it if you are migrating manually your WordPress install. Cool. So that was the database level commands. And now one of the most important command when you are transferring your WordPress website on, or when you are launching your WordPress website from your local host to the live website, one of the most important command is search and replace. So for example, if we go to our website, it will replace all of the URLs of your WordPress system. If it's in database, if it's in content, it will replace every single instance from your WordPress website. We can do an example by adding a string to our page and simply replace it using command line interface. So we have this page. Now let's edit this page and let's oldurl.com. Sorry, newurl.com. Update. Now let's preview the page. Now imagine you have images from this URL attached to your WordPress website, and you have this URL as your local host, and this is your new URL. Sorry, I mistakenly forget about it. So you can simply replace all of the URL instances using this one single command, which is search and replace. Now let's get into it. Now what I'm gonna do, I'll type in WP search replace. Sorry, there should be no space. WP search dash replace. And now first add in your old URL, which is in our case, this one, oldurl.com. And after that, in inverted comma, in commas, type in your new URL, which is this one. Now hit enter and it will instantly replace all of the old URLs to the new URLs. And I'm seeing an issue here because it says made one replacement. It should be multiple replacements. Let's see if we are doing any typo. WP search replace. All URL, new URL. Let's try it again. Made zero replacement, it should be done. Let's flush our cache before checking. Okay, now let's go to the front end. And so here's our current page. Now after, let's refresh. And there we go. All of the URL instances which we wanted to replace has been replaced with just one command line. So if you have multiple pages, multiple media library attached to one specific URL, you can simply run this command and make it done within a second. Okay, so that was our search replace command. Now let's get into the user management commands which we have. So in order to do so, we have one command which is WP user list, which will list all of the users which we currently have in our website. We can also list more detail for one specific user. For example, let's do this one. Oops, sorry, it's WP user Bilal. Sorry, WP user get then username. That's it. So that's for listing. That's for listing all of the users, and this command WP user get and then username is for finding out more detail about one specific user if you want to. Now we can also create a user using command, which is WP user create and then username. Let's create a test user. So the username will be test user, and let's add a test email for that user. Role should be editor, first name should be test, first last name, should be test last, and password should be, just let's say it's password. Okay, there we go. Okay, now hit enter. User underscore password parameter. So we added a one wrong parameter. So it's not user password, it's actually user pass. So I'm gonna type out the command again. Okay, here we go. WP user create test user, role editor, first name, last name, and user pass. Done. Hit enter. And here we go. Our user has been created. So if we list our users again, we will see a new user which we created, which is test user. And let's get some more detail about this test user. So the role is editor and the user login is email. Okay, we are good with the user management command list also. So there are many more commands available. I just listed out the basic one and the most oftenly usable command lines which you might be using on the WP-CLI. If you want to learn more about using these commands, and if you want to learn more commands, just put in the comment below and I'll try to make another tutorial videos for you guys. Till then, have a great day.